today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a PayPal account in Nigeria that sends and receives money online. So let's get started with the video. So once you head to the PayPal website on a Nigerian PC, it's going to show you a page just like this, and this is how the Nigerian phone looks like. As you can see, it only has a personal account here, so you can only pay online. But what you want to do on this page is that you want to come to the address bar right here, and you want to delete this, and you want to type in ls/home. So that will be paypal.com/ls/home. So once you do this, you want to click on enter. And once you click on enter, it's going to show you the Lesotho own. And as you can see, the difference between the Lesotho PayPal and the Nigerian PayPal is that the Lesotho PayPal has a business account which can allow you to get paid on your website or allow you to get paid through PayPal, not only paying online. So you can get paid or make payments. So now, as you can see, for this number, that's going to create on sign up. So once we create on sign up, we're going to see something like this. And for the personal account, if you just want to use PayPal to receive money online, you can create a personal account. But if you want people to pay you from a website or any place you put your PayPal link, you just simply want to click on business account and you want to click on continue. So once you do this, it's going to load you up to the next page, which is going to ask you for your email address. So you simply want to insert your email address. So as you can see on the screen now, it says that you insert my email address. So I'm just going to use this email address for the purpose of this video. And you want to click on continue after inserting your Gmail address. And next, it's going to ask you for a password. So most Chrome users, password normally suggests itself, and most times you need to type in a password. So for this one, I'm going to use a password, and I'm going to type in this password, and I'm going to add this to the newly created account. So I'm just going to click on continue. Okay, it says both uppercase and lower cases. So I'm just going to add an uppercase and a lower case to this password. So as you can see, I've added the uppercase and the lower case, and I'm going to click on continue. And as you can see, it says you should insert your business name right here. So what you want to first do is that if you don't have a business name, actually you can use your own name. If your name is Frank, you just want to type in Frank dot ltd, and that's what you want to type. And legal business name, you just want to type in Frank Enterprises dot ltd. So once you do this, and you just want to come down to this side and say the business name, you just still want to put the Frank. And for this, for the business phone number, yeah, what you want to do is that you want to quickly change this to a Nigerian phone number. As you can see here, it's set to Lesotho. So you want to change this to a Nigerian phone number, and this is how you do that. So you just want to go down and change this to a Nigerian phone number. So as you can see, I'm scrolling down and I'm going to click on Nigeria once I find Nigeria. So as you can see, this is the Nigerian phone number, which is +234. You can choose the phone number for any of the countries you live in. So I'm just going to add in my Nigerian phone number here, and then I'm going to receive an SMS telling me to confirm this. So now I'm just going to put that, and I'm just going to leave the address line 1 and 2, or I'm going to still add an address. If you have a home address, you can simply add that. So for this, I'm just going to use an address from my system already, which I've already saved. But for this, you can still change this to your own email address. So after doing this, you want to set your postal code and your state and region here. So you want to set the state and region. Actually, you can choose any of that. As you can see there, actually you can see there's the city already. So you can skip all this for now, and later you can actually add all this if you like. So I'm just going to skip on this, and I click by clicking agree and continue. I agree to the user agreement and privacy statement. Once you have done this, you just want to simply scroll down and you want to click on agree and continue. So just click on agree and continue, and it's going to load you up to a new page entirely. And on this new page, you're still going to add a little bit of details about your business. It says business type, and you simply want to choose a sole proprietor, as you can see right here. And for products and services, you can choose what you like doing the most. For me, I like video and making videos on YouTube, so I can just put video production or video marketing, or you can see down right here, electronics, video, amusements, game supplies, motion, and many others. So for this one, I'm just going to choose video game, and this for business URL, if applicable. For now, you just want to leave this way. You can actually set these things by yourself once you are inside the PayPal home page. So for this, you just want to add a date of birth, and you want to click on this and add in your date of birth. I'm just going to pick a random date of birth, and I'm going to add that to my PayPal account that I'm creating right now. So you just want to add anything, and you can say for nationality, you can change that to Nigeria back. So actually, you can use a Nigerian address and Nigerian details to sign in or to create a PayPal account. So for identity documents, you just want to leave this blank for now. There is a link in the description of this video where you can get free ID numbers. So just head to the description of this video and take those ID numbers and put them here. So after you submitted the ID number from the link in the description below, you're going to get directed to a page like this where it says, welcome to your PayPal business account. Get paid now, request form and send invoice. So you're just going to see this page up like this, and you can see set payment up online, and this is it. You have officially created your PayPal account. But for now, you just want to click on summary right here. So if you click on summary, it's going to take you to the homepage of your PayPal account, and you're going to see your PayPal balance. So that's how easy it is to create a PayPal account here in Nigeria. So you can see it says confirm email address, add your debit card. So for this, to add a debit card, you need US bank card, and you can add this to PayPal. So you can just click on see details right here, and once you click on see details, it's going to load it to a page where it's going to ask you to put a debit or a credit card, so that when you have money, you can link this to that card. So you can click on link a bank account or link a credit card, and once you do this, you go through the necessary requirements and you are good to go. So for now, as you can see, I have just created a PayPal account right here, and it says you have not linked anything. So for now, I'm just gonna show you guys this is how it looks like here. This is it right here. PayPal works without a balance, and also you can have no balance and your PayPal account will still be available to new customers and many people. So that's how you can easily create a PayPal account in Nigeria or anywhere. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. So right now on the screen, you're going to see a video about how to get Premiere Pro. Click on that video and go watch how to get Premiere Pro.